Namaste, Soul Circle!
I'm Steven.
I'm Candice.
And we're from Arcana, Mind, Body, Spirit, located in Toronto, Canada.
Today begins our next deep dive. Our topic, the chakras. Each week, we'll be diving into one of our major energetic centers. So be sure to hit subscribe and the notification bell to be sure you don't miss any of our upcoming episodes.
Now, if you commit to one chakra per week with us, we promise that come 2 months' time, you will have a more balanced body temple and mind space, which will enable you to manifest your highest potential. Ready to do the work?
Let's do it.
This season is all about intention and emergence. So we chose to work on our chakras so that by the time Beltane arrives on May 1st, we are in high order for manifestation. We'll be doing this by working through our body's major energy centers. Now, our body has hundreds of these energetic centers. Imagine them all like busy traffic intersections in our body where we store, transmute, send, and receive energy. And our body has 7 of these major centers, and these are called our chakras, which means wheel in Sanskrit.
The chakra system first appeared in India, dating back as early as 1500 BC. They are mentioned in the first sacred texts of Hinduism, known as the Vedas. Nowadays, we often associate chakra work with New Age concepts, but for thousands of years, the chakra system has been fundamental in practices worldwide, even if called by different names or placed in slightly different places.
The term balancing is used because chakras are, at their most basic definition, a major focal point through which energy flows up and down our entire physical body. These energy centers don't just govern the well-being of our body's physical properties, they also impact the emotional and spiritual balance, which is achieved by working through these centers.
Depending on your training, some belief systems say there are thousands of chakras in the body, all with correspondences to different energy lines and meridians throughout our body. Even practices like traditional Chinese medicine, reflexology, and acupuncture subscribe to these energy center theologies.
However, what it really comes down to is a set of 7 primary chakras that align with the spinal cord and stretch from the bottom of your spine all the way up to the top of your head, each governing a different aspect of our life. Now, there is a misconception about chakras. A lot of the time we focus on how our chakra isn't working, and which means it's not spinning correctly. But it's also just as harmful to have an overactive chakra as well.
For example, if we look at our sacral chakra, which governs sexuality and creation, being too sexually driven can be just as bad as fearing your sexuality. This will be something we unpack in upcoming episodes.
Will it ever?
Yeah.
So let's have a quick overview, shall we, of each of our chakras. Okay, so first we have our root or our base chakra. This is our stability, our feeling of safety, and how we gain groundedness.
Yep. Then we have our sacral, which is our creativity and sexuality.
Next, moving up, we have our solar plexus. This is where our self-confidence and our self-image lives.
And then it's our heart. So this is how we give and receive love.
Moving up, we have our throat. This is how we deal with communication, and it's our relationship to speaking our own truth.
Then we have our third eye, our intuition, perspective, and perception of all that we see.
Lastly, we have our crown. This is our connection to source and spirituality.
Imagine all the things you could do and feel if you had all of these spinning in balance. It really is key to raising your vibration.
Yeah, it's the goal every time we do any energy work at the beginning of any ceremony, practice, and even just daily when you wake up. Now, these 7 set up our central channel known in Sanskrit as our Shishumna. It's our column where our energy rises through our chakras up from our root up towards our crown. And as we raise our frequency, this is the column in which we are working with. Now, good posture and even meditative poise can naturally help align this. Now, fun fact, did you know that all living things actually have its own chakra system? And even the earth itself has chakra points located in sacred sites all over the world, including Mount Shasta, Lake Titicaca, Glastonbury, and even the pyramids of Giza.
For our upcoming episodes, we will be focusing on one chakra a week. So on Mondays, we'll be discussing the teachings and integration, prompting questions about what we are working on with the chakra, which we encourage you to participate in. We will also be having a weekly sound bath, as well as an episode on practices you can do from the comfort of your own home. This is where we give you some techniques to help unearth that chakra together. And then lastly, on Fridays, we'll be doing mala work. So, what is a mala, you ask? It's a meditative tool traditionally made with 108 beads. And we'll be using the Bija mantras that correspond to each chakra. In daily practice, this helps us uncover what is stored within.
In our practice, we believe we must be embodied as a part of ceremony, and we try and integrate that into our daily life. Not to say that you can't sit in circle when you aren't operating at a high frequency. Of course, sometimes you will feel like you are vibrating lower or higher than others. This is just natural. It is always important to reset your energy, though, sometimes even just by sitting up straight and taking a calming breath. Each week, we'll be discussing ways towards better alignment and gaining a higher vibration.
At the end of the day, a healthy mindset hinges on your body temple and your connection to it. So be sure to hit like and subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode.
I'm actually super excited for the next 2 months.
Me too.
Just spending the time and doing the work on every chakra, I think it's gonna help understanding, integration, and just having a healthy body temple.
Yeah. When you do the work, you see the results.
Absolutely. So we can't wait. Please leave comments below if there's any chakras that you know right away you need some work on. And if you have any ways that you like to work on those, please, we'd love to hear.
Yeah.
Love it all. Thanks for being here.
Much love.
Namaste.